Hello students, now we are going to start the chapter number 1 of the standard 8. Right, the name is a rational numbers. So first of the introduce this chapters here the standard 8 chapter number 1 is called the name is rational numbers. Okay, we begin our study of the numbers is counting numbers, right? So all counting numbers, just like the 1, 2, 3, 4, right, it is called the natural numbers, right? It is called the natural numbers, right? So all counting numbers is a positive integers. Okay, so now you just see that first that the natural numbers, okay, you already learned in a previous standards. Okay, so natural numbers, so the 1, 2, 3, 4, so on, right? It is called the natural number, also the counting numbers, right? It is also say the positive integer. Clear? Okay. Now you put in 0. And this set is become the whole numbers, right? You include in the here the 0, so it is called the whole numbers. Right? So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on, right? It is the whole numbers. Understand? Okay. Then after, all integer numbers, all integer numbers. Okay. So you introduce also the negative numbers, right? So for example, dash, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on. It is called the all integer numbers. Understand? Okay. So all are you learn is in a simple basis of the standard 6 and 7, right? So this is the counting number, it also the positive integer numbers and natural number. Then after the whole numbers, 0 including in this one counting numbers, the whole numbers and all integer numbers, then negative integers are at this, right? So the all are the numbers, clear? It is the set of natural numbers and the set of the all integer numbers, clear? Z. Okay, so you learn and depends on these numbers, you learn the some properties. Okay, and operations you already learn in the previous standards, right? Which kind of the operation normally you learn? Okay, so just see that operations. Okay, which operation you learn? The first one is addition, right? Okay, second subtraction. Okay, third multiplication. Okay, fourth division, right? They are the operation of the nature of numbers, integers numbers. Clear? Okay, now here the properties. Right? Okay. So property, which property you already learned? The first property is closure property. Right? Second is commutative. Right, third is associative property, then existence of first is identity, right? past is existence of inverse, right? Okay, so you will learn first is a closure, second is a commutative property, associative property, existence of the identity. Existence of identity matlab is there are the two types, okay, applicable on addition and multiplication. You any numbers add in zero, right? So you got the same numbers, 5 plus 0, 5, right? 7 plus 0, 7. So this 0 is called the existence of the identity, right? Clear? And then after, and the existence multiplication, 5 1s are 5, 7 1s are 7, 10 1s are 10. So 1 is a, okay, existence identity of multiplications, right? Then after, inverse, what is the inverse? How can you say that the inverse? So simple, the product of two numbers. Product of two numbers is called, simple, the inverse of the both the numbers. Right? For example, 2 and 1 by 2. Then product, you get the answer 1. 2 to cut, right? So 2 and 1 by 2 is the inverse of each other. 2, the inverse of 2 is equal to 1 by 2. And now 1 by 2 inverse is 2. Clear? So the, already you learned in this kind of property. Okay, so now we introduce the new number set is called the rational numbers, right? Understand? Okay, so rational numbers. Okay, which kind of number is called the rational numbers? Okay, so simple, a numbers, okay, which can express in the form of the P by Q form, right? Okay, so just see that matlab P and Q are both are compulsory integer. Okay, integer matlab no fractions are there. So here the rational numbers, so okay, a number which can be expressed in the form of P by Q, in the form, okay, P by Q, where P by Q, sorry, where P and Q are integer, right, and Q does not equal to 0, then is called a rational number. Clear? So what is the rational numbers? Any numbers can represent by P by Q. Okay, so P is P and Q are the compulsory integers, okay, and Q does not equal to 0. Okay, it is called the rational numbers. Clear? Okay, so this is called the rational numbers. So here, simple examples, some of examples of the rational number. Okay, first of that, 7 by 9, now minus 2 by 3, okay, minus 11 by minus 9, okay, and 3 by minus 5, right? They all are example of the one kind of the rational numbers. Okay, which form? P by Q form, and both are integer, and the your Q, okay, is not equal to 0. So they all are example of the rational numbers. Okay, the integer numbers that have the new set is called the number set is called the rational numbers. Clear? Okay, this is the example of the rational numbers. Now here, so here the rational numbers is a P by Q form. So P is called the numerator and Q is called the denominators, right? So P is called the numerator and Q is called the denominator. Clear? Okay. So this form is called the rational numbers. Okay. Here the same sign of numbers. Okay. This number is called the positive number. Right? The same sign, that means the minus 2 by minus 3, minus minus plus 2 by 3. So this one is a positive. Okay. And 5 by 7, it is also the positive. So here both positive, here both negative. So that's why the number is called the positive number. Otherwise it is negative. Okay. Otherwise it is negative. Right. So for example, so negative, that means the simple minus 2 by 3 minus 8 by minus 9. So one of the two of them, numerator, denominator, our sign is negative, the number is called the negative numbers. Clear? Okay. So they are the important point, because in algebra, every times you solve the and mistakes of the positive negative sign. Right? So positive number will have same sign of the P and Q. And P and Q are the different sign. One positive and one negative. That's it. Always number become negative. Clear? Okay? Understand? Okay? Okay. So natural numbers are okay, all integer, and you start the rational numbers. So rational number are is a fraction form. Clear? Okay. So here though, if the P and Q is the rational numbers and M is a non-zero integer, because Q does not equal to 0 here. So non-zero integer, then P by Q, we multiply the P also into M, and here the Q also the M, right? So both values are equivalent. How? Okay, so 7 by 9 is a number. You here multiply the 7 in 2. M is equal to 2 and Q is equal to 2. And you multiply the same number of the denominator and okay, and the numerator and denominator, right? So the value is equal to 14 by 18. So this both values are equivalent values, right? Clear? So these both are the called the equivalent value. Clear? So the simple first property, if the P and Q is a rational numbers, okay, you multiply the same numbers of the numerator, denominator. Okay, numerator and denominator, the both are the equivalent. P by Q is equal to P cross M and into Q cross M. Okay, so this both are the equivalent value. Okay, so 7 by 9 is equal to 14 by 18. Okay, because the you learn the HCF, right? So this is the HCF. Okay, and then you multiply. Just see that. Okay, now P by Q is a rational numbers and M is a common divisor of P and Q. Okay, so the common divisor and the same divisor, that means that they are the multiple of the both the numbers, yeah, divisor of the both the numbers, right? So P by Q is equal to P divided by M and Q divided by M. Both are equivalent. How? Right? A simple example. Suppose 3 by 9 is a number. Clear? So we divide the common divisor. So we common divisor is our 3. So simple 3 divided by 3 upon 9 divided by 3 is equal to 1 by 3. 3 by 3 is 1 and 9 by 3 is 3. 3 is 9, so 3. See, these both numbers are equivalent. Okay, so this is the simplest form, right? So now that see that lowest form of the rational numbers. Lowest form, the meaning of the second meaning is equal to simplest form, right? So very important in algebra, okay? So the simple rational numbers P by Q is said to be in the form of the simplest or lowest form if okay P and Q have no common factor other than 1. Okay, no common factor other than 1. Okay, understand? Okay, just see that. The one example of this. Okay, first of that, here the one number is 15 upon 21. Make the simplest form, yeah, lowest form of the given numbers, integers. Okay, sorry, given the rational numbers. So 15. So 5 threes are 15, right? And 7 threes are 15. So 3. What is 3? 3 is HCF of both the numbers. Understand? Okay, you cut it and you got the 5 by 7. Right? Okay. So this 5 by 7 is called simplest form. Simplest form. Simplest form of 15 by 21. Understand? Clear? So this 5 by 7 is the simplest form of the 15 by 21. Understand? Clear? Okay. So this one is a very important simplest form. So one mark questions. Okay. And you apply any one of the addition and subtraction portions. Right? Okay. Okay. The new topic is equality of the rational numbers. So here are the two rational numbers, is a p by q and r by s are equal if and only if p cross s is equal to q cross r. Okay, you see that? So first natural numbers of p by q is equal to the another rational numbers r by s, right? So why this equal p cross a if and only if? So p cross s is equal to, right, r cross q, right? Okay, so then it is both are equal, right? This is the equality of normally the rational number. So that means p q r s. So first cross multiply, the first arrow, this product of this is equal to, okay, product of these two numbers, right? So is this simple? Here the numerator of p is a numerator of the first number, okay, into denominator of second, right, is equal to here, right, and this r into s. Okay, so numerator of second into denominator of first, right? Here, this is the equality of the two rational numbers. Okay, so p into s is equal to r into q. Clear? Okay, so here the okay, one example, suppose here the 7 by 9, okay, suppose 7 by 21 is equal to, okay, 3 by 9, right? Okay, so both are equal because, so the numerator of first and denominator of second, so 7 into 9 is equal to, okay, so numerator of second and denominator of first, right? Okay, so both are same because 7 9s are and 21 3s are, both are 63. Clear? So it is called the equality of the rational numbers. Clear? Okay, understand? Okay, then now the addition of the rational numbers. So the simple, so there we have the two case, rational number with the same denominator and rational number with the distinct denominator, right? So it's very important because the we add and subtract, multiply and divide operations, okay, operate with easily for this property, right? So rational numbers with the same denominator. So there are the two rational numbers. One rational number is a p by q and other is a r by q. Then add this number p by q plus r by q is equal to p plus r by q. Understand? So you multiply, is very simple here. Okay, so p by q, one rational number, the denominator same, then put here and the addition of the two numerators of the both the numbers. Clear? Okay. Understand? So we are more easy to solve the so many questions, right? So just see that examples of the addition of the two rational numbers with the same denominator, right? Okay. Right. So addition with the same denominator of the both the numbers. So here just see that denominator are same, 5 clear? So add it. So 3 by 5 plus 13 by 5. So by formulas P plus this, right, upon denominator. So upon denominator is simple. So 3 plus 13, right? So V equal to 13 plus 3, both positive. So addition, same sign. Okay, so 16 by 5 is our answer. Clear? Okay, now the addition of these two numbers. So 7 by 9 plus minus 12 by 9. Okay, so denominator is 9. You know that one number is positive and one number negative. So opposite sign is always subtraction and put the greater number sign. So first subtract 12 minus 7. How much? 5, right? And put greater number sign. So here the minus 5 by 9. Understand? Okay. Now, okay, add this. So the minus 5 by 9 plus minus 17 by 9. So here minus 5 plus minus 17 and by 9. Right? Okay. Here both the sign are same. Minus 5, minus 17. Right? Minus 5 and minus 17. So minus 5 and minus 17, that means 22. Right? Addition it. Because same sign always addition and put greater number sign. So here 22 by 9. Put, okay, greater number sign. Understand? Okay. Now the fourth one. Okay. So add the 4 upon minus 11. Yes. It's very simple. So 4 by minus 11 plus 7 by 11. Here you return at this kind of this 4 minus 11 minus 4 upon 11 plus 7 by 11. Okay. So therefore minus 4, okay, plus 7 by 11. Because this signs are you put in numerator and denominator single one. So we have always put in numerator. Right? Okay. So the 7, they are the opposite sign. Minus 4 and plus 7. So opposite sign always subtraction. 7 minus 4, 3. And by 11. 7 is a positive, greater number. So that the sign is positive. So 3 by 11. Understand? Clear? Okay. Okay. Now the second. This one. So raise the numbers with the distinct denominators. Okay, the first one is the same denominator. You just normally the so that the sums, right? So you understand the this concept. Okay. Now also we understand this concept by the some illustration. So the here the is more important things is the LCM, right? Okay. So first of that, here the distinct denominator. So for example, 5 by 12 and add this. Okay, 5 by 12 and 3 by 8. See here, 12 and 8 are not the same numbers, same denominators. Okay, so what will we do? So take LCM. Okay, LCM of 12 and 8. Okay, compulsory, your first steps. Okay, so the 12 and 8. So LCM of this common, okay, multiple, lowest common multiple. So 12 and 8. Right? Okay. So, first 2. So, here 6 and 4. Okay. 2. Here 3 and 2. Again 2. Okay. 3 and 1. Clear? And now, here the simple way is a 3. So, 1, 1. So, the 2 2's are 4. 4 2's are 8. And 8 3's are 24. So, therefore, LCM of both the numbers is 24. Got it? Now, here the 5 by 12 plus 3 by 8 is equal to 5 by 12. You need 24, okay, your LCM. So, with number multiply into 12 and you got 24. So, number 2, right? So, here the 2 into 2, same multiple, right? Plus, same thing, 3 by 8. Right, into which number multiply and we get 24, so 3. Understand? Okay, so now here the 5 2's are 10 by 24 plus 9 by 24. Clear? Okay, so the same case 1, denominator is same and then addition is possible. So now here the 24, 10 plus 9. Is equal to 19 by 24 is our answer. This is also the, you say that the simplest form. Why? Why it is the simplest form? Because no P and Q, okay, no common factors other than 1, right? Both are the different number, okay, no common factors, okay, it is also called the simplest form, clear? One more sum. So explain the easily this concept, okay, the first is normally the 7 by 9 and 4, right, 7 by 9 and 4, here 7 by 9 plus 4 by 1, because all integer is all also rational numbers, right, so the 4 by 1, so LCM of, okay, 9 and 1 is 9, clear, so LCM how much, 9, clear, okay, so now 7 by 9 plus 4 by 1 is equal to 7 by 9, so we multiply the numbers 1, because 9 ones are 9, plus 4 upon 1, so we take our LCM is equal to 9, so 9 ones are 9, right, so here 7 ones are 7 by 9 plus, here the 9 fours are 36 by 9, so we got same denominator, okay, so 7 plus 36 is equal to 43 by 9 is our answer, clear, okay, understand, okay, so now continue and one more sum. Simplify, that means the, so 8 minus 15 plus normally, right, and the 4 upon minus 3, clear, so here simple minus 8 by 15 and minus 4 by 3, so we take the LCM of the 15 and 3, understand, okay, so now both are negative here, so the LCM of 15 and 3, both are in the same tables, okay, so the bigger number is LCM, so 3 and 15 suppose, so 3 ones are 3 and here 5 and 5 ones are 5, so 15, right, so LCM is become 15, so minus 8 by 15, okay, and minus 4 by 3 is equal to, first minus 8 by 15, which number we multiply get 15 of denominator, so 1, right, and minus 4 by 3, we multiply by 5 and 3 5s are 15, the same numbers multiply in numerators. So therefore, minus 8 by 15 and minus 20 by 15. So put here 15, right? So minus 8 and minus 20, same sign always addition and put greater number sign. So is equal to minus 28 by 15. Right, so this one is our answer of this simplifications, clear, understand, okay, now rational numbers, right, the question 1 is a minus 5 by 7 and 3 by 7, right, first number, so both are the, check the same denominator, right, so here the minus 5 by 7 plus 3 by 7, okay, just check it, so minus 5 plus 3 by 7, because same denominator, so we put directly, so 5 opposite sign, 5 is negative and 3 is positive, so always subtraction, 5 minus 3 2 and put greater number sign, right, so minus 2 by 7 is answer, okay, now 2, another 2 number, minus 15 by 4 and 7 by 4, right, okay, so here माइनस 15 बाय 4 प्लस 7 बाय 4 इज इक्वल टू माइनस 15 बाय 7 एंड बाय 4. सो 15 बाय माइनस 15 एंड प्लस 7, सो दे आर ऑपोजिट साइन, तो कंपल्सरी सब्ट्रैक्शन. सो पुट माइनस 8 एंड बाय 4. ओके, तो बट फर्स्ट इन सिंपलेस्ट फॉर्म, सो यू नो दैट 4 2 जार 8, सो यू गॉट माइनस 2 बाय 1, या माइनस 2 इज योर आंसर. अंडरस्टैंड? ओके, क्लियर? नाउ द क्वेश्चन टू, एड द फॉलोइंग रेशनल नंबर्स. सो दे आर द टू रेशनल नंबर्स, सो वी एड दिस, सो 3 बाय 4 माइनस, हियर द माइनस 5 बाय 8. Here the denominator are not same. So first step is take the LCM. Here both are the same tables. 4 1s are and 4 2s are 8, right? So the bigger number is our LCM. Right? So then, okay, first try 4 1s are 4, right? 2 here, the 2. Got it? The 4 2s are 8 is our LCM. So LCM is 8. So 3 by 4 plus माइनस 5 बाय 8 इज इक्वल टू 3 बाय 4 मल्टीप्लाई. ओके, सो 3 मल्टीप्लाई बाय 2, ओके सॉरी 4 इंटू 2 8, 4 2 आर 8, सो वी मल्टीप्लाई बाय 2 इन बोथ न्यूमरेटर एंड डिनोमिनेटर प्लस माइनस 5 बाय 8. सो वी टेक, वी वांट टू 8, सो 8 1 आर 8, ऑलरेडी 8, सो इंटू 1, सो 2 3 आर 6 बाय 8 एंड प्लस माइनस 5 बाय 8. डिनोमिनेटर सेम, तो 6 माइनस 5 बाय 8, सो सब्ट्रैक्शन, सो आंसर इज इक्वल टू 1 बाय 8. क्लियर? ओके, नाउ माइनस 5 बाय 9 एंड 7 बाय 3. सो हियर अगेन माइनस 5 बाय 9 वी रिटर्न एंड 7 बाय 3. ओके, टेक द एलसीएम बिकॉज डिनोमिनेटर आर नॉट सेम, बट 3 3 आर 9. So it's very simple, LCM, right, is equal to 9. So minus 5 by 9 plus 7 by 3 is equal to minus 5 by 9 multiply by 9 we need. So 9 ones are 9 plus 7 by 3. So we need 9, so 3 3s are 9. So we multiply numerator and denominator by 3. So here the minus 5 upon 9 plus 21 by 9. So minus 5 plus 21 by 9, because denominator equal. So both are different sign, so subtraction, 21 minus 5, 16, greater number sign positive. So our answer is equal to 16 by 9. Right? And now last one, minus 7 by 27 plus 11 by 18. So the 27 and 18 are the not same denominator. So first take the LCM. Okay, so LCM of the numbers, so 18 and 27. Okay, first of 2, so 9, 27 as it is, 3, 3 3s are 9, 9 3s are again 3, 1s are 3, and 3, 1, 1. Got it? So 2, 3s are 6, 6, 3s are, okay, 6, 18, and 18, 3 are 54. So the LCM is become 54, right? So minus 7 by 27, okay, multiply, we need 54. So 7 or 27, 2s are, right, plus 11 by 18. So 11, 3s are, so we multiply numerator and denominator by 3. Here the minus 14, okay, upon 54. Plus 33 by 54. So here the 54. Okay. So minus 14 and plus 33. Again, they are the opposite sign. Always subtract sign and put greater number sign. So 33 minus 14. So 13 minus 4, 9. And 2 minus 1, 1. So positive 19 by 54. Right? This is our answer. Clear? You understand these things? Okay. So please students, first you watch the video, okay, and okay, proper fan out of these videos, right? and also I put the some DBP and you solve it in the fair notebook. We discuss in our the doubt lectures. Got it? Understand? Okay. Bye.